Let's look at the current administration's efforts, sir. To combat El Nino, they launched this Project Lawa. Do you know of any of your members who are benefiting from this?
Well, I'm not very familiar with that new term. But the point is, I think that the government is now redoubling its efforts so that our, in particular, our farmers and fisher folk are better prepared and better equipped to deal with the onset of El Nino, both in the first and second quarters of this year. So to some extent, there are preparations going on, but I think we still have to redouble efforts to make sure that the preparations will be going full blast.
Just for context for those for our viewers, Mr. Montemayor, Project Lawa is a project by the government that aims to give more irrigation to, for now, at least select provinces in the country. Let's talk about irrigation now. Do you think that the irrigation is enough for our farmers?
Right now, well, overall, even without El Nino, our irrigated area is not enough. So I was in the office of the administrator of the National Irrigation Administration, Administrator Eddie Guillen, the other day, and he presented to me their immediate plans to address both the middle to longer term requirements for irrigation, as well as the short-term requirements in view of the forthcoming El Nino. So I think the NIA in particular is doing its level best to do the preparations, but I hope we have enough time between now and, you know, the start, in particular of the second quarter, to make a significant dent in the irrigation needs, especially for El Nino.
Let's hope that the president's promise to finish all irrigation projects up until April of this year would actually come to fruition. Let's now move to importation to augment supply. You already mentioned earlier, sir, that we're waiting for importation from different countries like India and Indonesia and Vietnam. But global prices of rice on the market is also getting higher. With importation coming in, hopefully to augment our supply, but the prices are still getting high. What can you say about this?
Yeah, well, that's the effect really of a free market system, free trade regime under the existing law, which is the Rice Tariffication Law. So essentially, under that law, government gave up its leverage in influencing the supply of rice in particular by leaving the importation totally to the private sector. If the National Food Authority was in a position, as it was before, to do direct importation, perhaps government could have a better handle in terms of trying to stabilize the prices of rice. But right now, its hands are tied. So government, however, is doing its best to encourage the private sector to import more. Unfortunately, as you pointed out, since the prices of rice abroad are quite expensive, I think many importers are not too keen in doing a lot of importation because they might lose their share. So later on, I think we have to have a deeper review of existing laws and policies so that government will be in a much better position to address challenges like what we're facing now.
Let's look at food productivity efforts, Mr. Montemayor. Sir, you have been the previous secretary. Since then, since when you have been in position, up until now, has there been any progress on promises of different administrations to at least enhance the capacity of farmers to produce rice?
Yes, I think there were some improvements, especially over the term of President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo and President Noynoy Aquino. But unfortunately, since the administration, I think, of President Duterte, things have taken, things have been for the worse. And there was an attempt to somehow recover during the start of the Marcos Jr. administration. Unfortunately, overall, the situation with respect not only to rice but also to agriculture in general has been at best, it has remained stagnant. So our agricultural growth overall has basically been flat. And with respect to rice, there has been some improvement, I think, over the past year. But our problem really is that our productivity record, as well as our absolute production of rice locally, is not very has not been enough to keep pace with our population growth. So, for example, as of the moment, actually during the past 2 years or so, our rice sufficiency level has only been at about 80%. So we have to import about roughly 20% of our total rice requirements every year. That's about roughly 3 million tons or more per year. So the problem right now is that while we still have, we had a fairly, as I said, fairly flat performance with respect to local rice production in 22 and also in 2023, importers are reluctant to import more to fill up that 20% gap to satisfy our local population. So that's really the big challenge right now, as well as ramping up domestic production to the extent that we can do so, especially in preparation for El Nino.
So many facets of this problem, sir, that we have to look at. And I know the government is trying hard to at least crack down on some important issues that we need to discuss. But for you, as a previous secretary, what do you think should be prioritized at the moment, sir?
Well, number one, as was pointed out earlier, irrigation will be critical. So to the extent that we can tap existing, water sources and through, solar powered irrigation systems that can quickly provide more water to our farmers, that should be done immediately. And then in the proper advice should be given to our farmers. So in places where irrigation water might not be sufficient for rice production, then farmers should be advised and assisted to shift to other crops which need less water, like corn, vegetables, and so on. So I think weather advisories, as well as the support in terms of planting materials and so on, will be very critical in order to minimize any significant reduction in our food supply, including rice, of course.
And finally, sir, before I let you go, do you have any advice for consumers in the coming months?
Yeah, we have to be much more, I think, economical in our use. So perhaps the unlimited rice policy that is now, we are used to enjoying in our restaurants or in our carinderias should now be tempered. Maybe instead of a full cup of rice, it should be half cup of rice. Avoid wastage as much as possible. I think we can significantly reduce, wastage in our rice consumption. That can go a lot in terms of also stabilizing and moderating any increases in the price of rice.
All right. Now I know, sir, that you're a frequenter of those Only Rice restaurants.
I'm a frequenter of reading the unlimited rice offers, but I try to reduce my rice intake.
Yes. Let's take care of our health. But thank you so much for your time, sir, and you have a good afternoon ahead of you.
Thank you very much also.
That's Sir Leonardo Montemayor, the board chairman and of Federation of Free Farmers.